is about some few tips that will help you in your music production career, and I'll try to speak in the perspective of a producer and an artist, and sometimes some of these points can work for both cases. And to start off, the first point is think like an entrepreneur. I would advise you to read the book Rich Dad Poor Dad, especially if you can read the whole series. But if you can't, you can start with the first one. Gives you the basics in some financial literacy. And the point of the book mainly is to help you differentiate between assets, liabilities, income and expenditure or expenses. And assets and income are things that put money in your pocket, and expenses and liabilities are things that take money out of your pocket. If you have a proper plan with your money, it can help you to get new gear for either for music production or for reinvesting in your brand. If you read that book, it will help you a lot, and I advise anyone to read that book. Learn to collaborate. Music groups are popular in Kenya today, like the Chongolo family, Rico gang, Ethnic, and all those kind of groups. So I believe, like, let's say if you're a group of four, because four is quite common, one of you is a producer, so he does the making of the beat and the mix and the mastering, and the other one is in charge of branding and the PR, and another person is in charge of songwriting, and another person can be in charge, let's say, of the photography and the videography. So then if you work like that, it can really help each other become self-sufficient in your group, in that music group, and you can be able to do a lot more things than if, let's say, you're just the producer, or just the songwriter, or just you're a musician, yes, and you can do film, you can do videography and photography. So sometimes working as a music group is an advantage. And or if not like a music group, like a collective where you assist each other in projects. Let's say the artist who is a producer also can be helping produce a song for someone else in the collective, or it can be the official producer of the collective, and the other guy, let's say, who is in charge of the photography and the videography, can be in charge of taking care of behind the scenes of the videos, shooting the music videos, like taking pictures and editing them for posting on social media, that kind of thing. And also, most of the times, if you notice in other, like, international bands, old play and the like, they could be having like a split sheet agreement where having a split sheet agreement is really good, because especially when you're starting out, since it helps you take care of any future disagreements that you may have. So maybe if you're in those, giving the same example of the music group of the four artists with different skill sets, you can decide that whatever money that you have as the four of us, as long as everyone puts the kind of input they are required to put, let's say every person gets 25% of the 100. Whatever money that you get maybe from a show, you decide to split the money in four ways. You can have it as a written agreement. You might need a lawyer to do that for you. And everyone has a copy so that everyone understands their contribution, and everyone understands how much each is supposed to get, so that in future, if there's any disagreements or if the band splits up, everyone can still get the royalties of the songs they made as a group. The third point is, especially when it comes to music producers, before you do anything, business first before you start recording of a project or creating a beat for someone. It helps because you don't end up putting a lot of time in a project and then you end up finding out that the artist is not financially able to reimburse you, or so you know you don't put a lot of time and effort where you could have put that time and effort in another project that is paying you. As a producer, sometimes you have to know your worth. Of course, you don't have to, when you're starting out, you don't try as much as possible to not to undersell yourself and also not to oversell yourself. But sometimes also, if your productions are really good, you can afford to go a bit higher than everybody else. But as long as the value is seen the right people will find you and will compensate you for your work. Fourth point is, don't sign anything you don't understand. Or if you have to sign anything, it's better to get a lawyer that you trust that can look at what you're signing for you. Point number five is, work with people that you trust and be transparent with in any kind of dealing. Point number six is, if you're a parent and you find out that your child is interested in or something related to in the creative arts, I think it will help if you help them nurture that talent and help them grow at it when they are young, so they have time to reach mastery, and also they don't have a lot of pressure to start bringing money because they are still young. Some of the big artists, most of them, they started with an instrument, a piano at the age of 4 or at 6 or at 8. By the time they reach at age 18, they are already at a level where if you are a person that is starting at 18 to play the piano, will have a harder time to reach to get that level of mastery compared to the one that started at the age of 6 or at 4. Especially when you're that young, you should try as much as possible to play, learning the basics, at least the piano and the guitar. Most people at least can play one or both of them, but also adding rare kind of instruments where not a lot of people can play, let's say the saxophone or the trumpet or harmonica or accordion or the bass. See you next time.